We are just getting started. We'd like to take this time to thank you and welcome you to tonight's production of Filling the Gap Theatrics, Overtones. This is a one-night production, so to have you here means the world to all of us, as you would if you were at the live theater. At this time, we ask that you turn off all mobile phones and pagers, if those still exist. The production does run about 35 minutes with no intermission. Because this is Zoom, there might be a delay or a lag in video. So if that occurs, just give it 1 second to reconnect. If you have not received a program via email, please check our Facebook page to read through a copy. We would like to advertise that as this is a free production, we would highly suggest donating the money you could have used to pay for a ticket to one of the many organizations that support the Black Lives Matter movement. If you're looking for an organization, please check the program. With all of that being said, thank you again, and please enjoy Overtones.
We're bloated. You're fat. You're sagging. We are fading. We have wrinkles. But we're strong. Thank you.
say. Life can be so sweet on the sunny side of the street. I used to walk in the shade with those blues on parade. But now I'm not afraid. This rover crossed over. If I never have a cent, I'll be rich as Rockefeller. Gonna set my feet on the sunny side of the street.
Harriet, my other self, my trained self.
Yes.
I want to talk to you.
Well.
Oh, Harriet, how beautiful you are today.
Am I presentable, Hetty?
Suits me.
I've tried to make the best of the good points.
My passions are deeper than yours. I can't keep the mask on as you do. I'm crude, but real. You are my appearance to the world.
I am what you wish the world to believe you are.
You are the part of me that's been trained.
I am your educated self.
I am the rushing river. You are the ice over the current.
I am your subtle overtones.
But together, we are one woman. The wife of Charles Goodrich.
There I disagree with you, Hetty. I alone am his wife.
Harriet, how could you say such a thing?
Well, certainly. I am the one who flatters him. I have to be the one who talks to him. If I gave you a chance, you would tell him at once that you dislike him.
I don't love him, that's certain.
You leave all the fibbing to me. He doesn't suspect that my calm, suave manner hides your hatred. Considering the amount of scheming it causes me, it can safely be said that he is my husband.
Oh, if you love him.
I haven't any feelings. It isn't my business to love anybody.
Then why need you object to calling him my husband?
I resent your appropriation of a man who is managed only through the cleverness of my artifice.
You may be clever enough to deceive him, Harriet, but I am still the one who suffers. I can't forget that he is my husband. I can't forget that I might have married John Caldwell.
How foolish of you to remember John, just because we met his wife by chance.
That's what I wanted to talk to you about. She might be here any moment. I wanted to advise you about what to say to her this afternoon.
By all means, tell me now and don't interrupt while she is here. You have the most annoying habit of talking to me when people are present. Sometimes it is all I can do to keep my poise and appear not to be listening to you.
Impress her.
Hetty, dear. Is it not my custom to impress people?
I hate her.
I can't let her see that.
I hate her because she married John.
Only after you refused him.
Was it my fault that I refused him?
Oh, that's right. Blame me.
It was your fault. You told me he was poor and was never going to be able to do anything in painting. Look at him now, known in Europe, just returned from 8 years in Paris. Famous.
It was too poor a gamble at the time. It was much safer to accept Charles's money and position.
And then John married Margaret within the year.
Out of spite?
Freckled, gawky-eye-looking thing she was, too.
Europe improved her. She was stunning the other morning.
Make her jealous today.
Shall I be haughty? Or cordial? Or caustic?
Above all else, you must let her know that we are rich.
Oh, yes, I do that quite easily now.
You must put on a bit.
No, never fear.
Tell her I love my husband.
My husband!
Are you going to quarrel with me?
No. I have no desire to quarrel with you. It is quite too uncomfortable. I couldn't get away from you if I tried.
You were a stupid fool to make me refuse, John, and I will never forgive you, never.
Don't get me all excited. I'll be in no condition to meet her properly this afternoon.
I could choke you for robbing me of John.
Oh, don't muss me.
You have no idea how you've made me suffer.
It is not my business to have heartaches.
You are bloodless. Nothing but a sham. A sham, while I...
Be quiet. I can't let her see that I've been fighting with my inner self.
And now, after all my suffering, you say that it has cost you more than it has cost me to be married to Charles? But it is the pain here in my heart. I've paid the price. I've paid. Charles is not your husband.
He is.
He isn't.
He is.
He isn't. I'll kill you.
Don't. Don't. You're stronger than I am. You're
say
stronger.
He's mine.
Ours.
There she is now.
Wait, I can't let the telephone girl down there hear my real self. It isn't proper. Show Mrs. Caldwell up.
I'm so excited. My heart's in my mouth.
A nice state you've put my nerves into.
Don't let her see you're nervous.
Quick, hide, or she'll see you shining through me.
Tell her Charles is rich and fascinating. Boast of our friends. Make her feel she needs us.
I'll make her ask John to paint us.
That was just my thought. If John paints our portrait,
we can wear an exquisite gown
and make him fall in love again.
Yes. Oh, Margaret, I'm so glad to see you.
That's a lie.
It's enchanting to see you, Harriet.
I'd bite you if I dared.
Wasn't our meeting a stroke of luck?
I've thought of you so often, Harriet, and to come back and find you living in New York.
Ugh, Mr. Goodrich has many interests here.
Flatter her.
Oh, I know, Mr. Goodrich is so successful.
Tell her we're rich.
Oh, won't you sit down?
What a beautiful lamp.
Oh, Do you like it? I'm afraid Charles paid an extravagant price.
I don't believe it.
I'm sure he must have.
How well you are looking, Margaret.
Yes, you are not. There are circles under your eyes.
I haven't eaten since breakfast, and I'm hungry.
How well you are looking, too.
You have hard lines about your lips. Are you happy?
Don't let her know that I'm unhappy.
Why shouldn't I look well? My life is full, happy, complete.
I wonder.
Tell her we have an automobile.
My life is complete, too.
My heart is torn with sorrow. My husband cannot make a living. He will kill himself if he does not get an order for a painting.
You must come and see us at the studio. John has been doing some excellent portraits. He cannot begin to fill his orders.
Why don't you stop her bragging and tell her we have an automobile?
Do you take lemon in your tea?
Take cream. It's more filling.
No, cream, if you please. How cozy.
Only cakes. Oh, I could eat them all.
How many lumps?
Sugar is nourishing.
3, please. I used to drink very sweet coffee in Turkey, and ever since I
don't believe you were ever in Turkey.
Well, I wasn't. It's none of your business.
Have you been in Turkey? Do tell me about it.
Change the subject.
You must go there. You have so much taste in dress, you would enjoy seeing their costumes.
Isn't she going to pass the cake?
John painted several portraits there.
Tell her we have an automobile.
Oh, cake?
Oh, at last.
Thank you.
Automobile!
Follow up the costumes with a suggestion that she would make a good model for John. It isn't too early to begin getting what you came for.
What delicious cake.
There's your chance for the auto.
Yes, it is good cake, isn't it? There are always a great many people buying it at Harper's. I sat in my automobile 15 minutes this morning waiting for my chauffeur to get it.
Make her order a portrait.
If you stopped at Harper's, you must have noticed all the new gowns at Henderson's. Aren't the shop windows alluring these days?
Even my chauffeur notices them.
I know you have an automobile. I heard you the first time.
I notice gowns now with an artist's eye, as John does. The one you have on, my dear, is very paintable.
Don't let her see you're anxious to be painted.
It's just a little model.
Don't seem anxious to get the order.
Perhaps it's not the gown itself, but the way you wear it that pleases the eye. Some people can wear anything with grace.
Yes, I'm very graceful.
You flatter me, my dear.
On the contrary, Harriet, I have an intense admiration for you. I remember how beautiful you were as a girl. In fact, I was quite jealous when John was paying you so much attention.
She's gloating because I lost him.
Those were childhood days in a country town.
She's trying to make you feel that John was only a country boy.
Most great men have come from the country. There's a fair chance that John will be added to the list.
I know it, and I'm bitterly jealous of you.
Undoubtedly, he owes much of his success to you, Margaret. Your experience in economy and your ability to endure hardship. Those first few years in Paris must have been a struggle.
She is sneering at your poverty.
Yes, we did find life difficult at first. Not the luxurious start a girl has who marries wealth.
Deny that you married Charles for his money?
But John and I are so congenial in our tastes that we were impervious to any hardship or unhappiness.
Do you love each other? Is that really true?
Did you have all the romance of starving for his art?
She's taunting you. Get even with her.
Not for long. Prince Rear soon discovered John's genius and introduced him royally to wealthy Parisians who gave him many orders.
Are you telling the truth or are you lying?
If he had many opportunities there, you must have had great inducements to come back to the States.
We did, but not the kind you think.
John became the rage among Americans traveling in France, too. And they simply insisted upon his coming here.
Whom is he going to paint here?
Oh, what names dare I make up?
Just at present, Miss Dorothy Ainsworth of Oregon is posing. You may not know the name, but she is the daughter of a wealthy miner who found gold in Alaska.
I dare say. There are many Western people we have never heard of.
You must have found social life in New York very interesting, Harriet, after the simplicity of our hometown.
Oh, there's no reason to remind us that our beginnings were the same.
Of course, Charles's family made everything delightful for me. They're so well connected.
Flatter her.
I heard it mentioned that you had made yourself very popular. Someone said you were very clever.
Who told you that?
Nobody.
Confidences should be suspected. Respected, I mean. They said, too, that you were gaining some reputation as a critic of art.
Oh, I make no pretenses.
Are you and Mr. Goodrich interested in the same things, too?
No.
Yes, indeed. Charles and I are inseparable.
I wonder.
Oh, have another cake?
Oh, yes.
I really shouldn't. After my big luncheon, John took me to the Ritz, and we were invited to the Bedfords for dinner. They have such a magnificent house near the drive. I really shouldn't, but the cakes are so good.
Oh, starving.
More tea.
Yes.
No, thank you. How wonderfully life has arranged itself for you. Wealth, position, a happy marriage. Every opportunity to enjoy all pleasures, beauty, art. How happy you must be.
Don't call me happy. I've never been happy since I gave up John. All these years without him. A future without him. No. No. I shall win him back. Away from you. Away from you.
I sometimes think it is unfair for anyone to be as happy as I am. Charles and I are just as much in love now as when we married. Oh, to me, he is just the dearest man in the world.
My John is. I'm going through hunger, and I want to make him great, and he loves me. He worships me.
I should like to meet Mr. Goodrich. Bring him to our studio. John has some sketches to show. Not many, because all the portraits have been purchased by the subjects. He gets as much as $4,000 now.
Don't pay that much.
As much as that?
It isn't really too much when one considers that John is in the foremost rank of artists today. A picture painted by him now will double and treble in value.
It's all a lie. He is growing weak with despair.
Does he paint all day long?
No, he draws advertisements for our bread.
When you and your husband come to see us, telephone first.
Yes, so he can get the advertisements out of the way.
Otherwise, you might arrive while he has a sitter, and John refuses to let me disturb him then.
Make her ask for an order.
Lagrange offered to paint me for $1,000.
Louis Lagrange's reputation isn't worth more than that.
Well, I've heard his work well mentioned.
Yes, he is doing splendid work.
Dear me, no. He's praised only by the masses. He's accepted not at all by artists themselves.
Must I pay full price?
Lagrange thought I would make a good subject.
Let her fish for it.
Of course she would. Why don't you let Lagrange paint you if you trust him?
She doesn't seem anxious to have John do it.
But if Lagrange isn't accepted by artists, it would be a waste of time to pose for him, wouldn't it?
Yes, I think it would.
Give us the order. John is so despondent, he can't endure much longer. Help us. Help me. Save us.
Don't seem too eager.
And yet, if he only charges 1,000, one might consider it.
If you really wish to be painted, why don't you give a little more and get a portrait really worthwhile? John might be used to do you for below his usual price, considering he used to be such good friends.
Hurrah!
That's very nice of you to suggest. Of course, I don't know.
Oh, for God's sake, say yes!
Of course, I don't know whether John would. He is very peculiar in these matters. He sets his value on his work and thinks it beneath him to discuss price.
You needn't try and make us feel small.
Still, I might quite delicately mention to him that, inasmuch as you have so many influential friends, you would be very glad to...
Finish what I don't want to say?
Help her out.
Of course. Introductions will follow the exhibition of my portrait. No doubt I...
Be patronizing.
No doubt I shall be able to introduce your husband to his advantage.
Oh, saved!
If I find John in a proprietous mood, I shall take pleasure, for your sake, in telling him about your beauty. Just as you are sitting now would be a lovely pose.
We can go now.
Don't let her think she's doing us a favor.
It will give me pleasure to add my name to your husband's list of patronesses.
Run home and tell John the good news.
I little guessed when I came here for a pleasant chat about old times that it would develop into business arrangements. I had no idea, Harriet, that you had any intention of being painted. By Lagrange, too. Well, I came just in time to rescue you.
Run home and tell John. Hurry, hurry!
You managed the order very neatly. She doesn't suspect that you wanted it.
Now, if I am not satisfied with my portrait, I shall blame you, Margaret, dear. I am relying upon your opinion of John's talent.
She doesn't suspect what you came for. Now run home and tell John.
You always had a brilliant mind, Margaret.
It is you who flatter now.
You don't have to stay so long. Hurry home.
One does not flatter when one tells the truth.
I must be going, or you will have me completely under your spell.
Yes, do go. I have to dress for dinner.
Don't hurry.
I hate you.
No, really, I must go, but I do hope we run into each other often at the studio. I find you so stimulating.
I hate you.
It is indeed gratifying to find a kindred spirit.
I came for your gold.
How delightful it is to know you again.
I'm going to make you and your husband suffer.
My kind regards to John.
He has forgotten all about you.
He will be so happy to receive them.
I can hardly wait to talk to him again.
I should wait then, until you send me word.
I'll speak to John about it as soon as I can, and tell you when to come.
I love him. I love him.
He's starving. I'm starving.
I'm going to take him away from you.
I want your money and your influence.
I'm going to rob you.
I'm going to rob you.
Rob you.
Rob you. Oh.
I've had such a delightful afternoon.
It has been a joy to see you.
Goodbye.
Goodbye, my dear.
Thank you so much for attending Filling the Gap Theatrics production of Overtones. We hope you have a wonderful Saturday night. Stay happy, stay healthy, stay well. Have a great night, everyone.